The film opens, and we see Brad, who is a pilot, as the main character. He is seen walking through the airport. Along with this, he was talking to his daughter on a video call. He tells her, "I will finish my work and come to see you soon." She becomes happy to hear this. Brad then heads to the pilot's cabin where he meets his colleague. The two pilots start talking about themselves. Brad is then called out. An officer informs him that due to an emergency, you must take a killer with you, who is a powerful person named Tony with him. "We're giving you his responsibility due to your sensibility," to which he agrees. He meets the rest of the crew and they discuss the passengers. Whether everyone has come or not. And as soon as all the passengers come and sit in the plane, then these people immediately take off. Brad tells his fellow pilot that he loves his daughter very much, and going to meet her very soon. "We have no one but each other." And then these people keep traveling in the plane till night. But then suddenly the weather starts getting worse. Because of this, Brad looks worried because he was not feeling well. He tells all the passengers to fasten their seat belts. Through the radio, he also tries to talk to his center. But he can't talk to them. Because slowly all the radios here stop working. And then suddenly a sharp shock of electricity comes from the plane and hits. Because of this, the plane starts moving. Brad was getting worried, so when he goes to see all the passengers, he breathes a sigh of relief. Because all the passengers were fine. And here the light was slowly turning off. In the middle, the plane is hit again. Because of this, Brad falls and his head is injured. Because of all these circumstances, all the passengers were in a bad state. Brad comes back to the cabin, and starts taking care of the plane with his companion. It was a very difficult time for them. Because the radio was not working. On top of that, nothing was visible in front of them on the screen. Then Brad says that we have to bring the plane down. Because if another shock is applied, the plane will be destroyed. So immediately these people start taking the plane down. All the passengers were scared. A woman then opens her seat belt. Seeing her, Tony's officer also does the same. Because the plane was going down, they hit hard from the top side. So hard that they immediately die. Suddenly the plane starts coming down quickly. Then Brad and his companion quickly control it. Then the air hostess tells Brad that the passengers are in a bad state. On this, he asked to manage everyone and ask them to sit on their seats. Because soon we are going to land at a nearby airport. Now, they see that we are passing over an island. So if there is no other way, they decide to land the plane on this island. Seeing a proper place, they then land the plane. Although they had landed in an emergency. But still, they landed safely. Now Brad and his companion are happy, when they come to know that some electricity is still in the plane. After which Brad tells everyone to get down. There the owner of the plane company also sees, that suddenly the plane has disappeared somewhere. Because he had not seen the plane landing. And for a long time, due to the radio being damaged, he could not contact. That's why he looks a little tense. Now the air hostess comes and tells Brad, that the officer who brought Tony has died. Brad gets sad to hear this, but he tells him that whatever happened, now take care of the rest of the passengers. Now everyone was wondering why we landed here. Because of this, Brad comes in front, and tells them that we had to land here due to an emergency. There is still a little electricity in the plane. With which we will fix the rest of the electricity. Till then you guys stay here comfortably. You will get food, water, and a place to stay. And you guys don't worry, we will leave here very soon. There the owner of the plane company meets a rescue expert. Who does the work of finding such people who are stuck in trouble. The company's manager tells him that I need all the details of my plane. Like where did it go, its workers, and all the information about the passengers. Now, Brad comes to the plane and starts fixing it. But he sees that the power electricity in the plane is very low. That's why they will have to wait, because the radio is also not working. Then when he tells this to his companion pilot, his companion sees the map and tells him, that we are stuck on a private island. This is not a free place, but it was captured by a private army here. Which was bad, because all of them were goons in it. And if they cause any harm to us, then the government will not be able to save us. Hearing this, Brad says that somehow we will have to call our rescue team here. So that they come and save us all. Because this is the only way to get out of here. Now, Brad comes to everyone and tells them that the radio is still not working due to some malfunction. Hearing this, all the passengers get very worried. Brad also convinces them that we will go to the other side of the island and find the radio. And we'll ask our team to send the rescue team here, which will come and save you all. And Tony will go with me. Saying this, he opens Tony's handcuff and these people move forward. Now, we see the head of the private army who were bad people. To whom a man comes and tells that a plane has come and stopped here on the island due to an emergency. And there are a lot of people in it who are from different countries. Hearing this, the head of the private army gives him money. He tells his team to get ready for this information. Because maybe these people were going to go with the intention of looting them. In the jungle of the island, Brad and Tony are moving forward. Tony asks Brad, "Why did you set me free, and where are you taking me now?" So Brad says that because of you, I can't put everyone in danger. And here is a dangerous private army, whom you have to face with me. And then he asks a lot of questions to Brad. And then suddenly he becomes quiet. So when Brad turns back and sees, Tony was not there. He was gone. There, the rescue expert goes busy in getting information about the plane. In a video, he sees Brad. He fights with the passenger and beats him a lot. Now seeing his fighting skills, the rescue expert was very happy. After this, he talks to the leader of a private company. Says that you people be ready. At any time we may need you. On which he says yes. In the jungle, Brad goes to an empty factory. Where he finds a closed radio machine. And then he fixes it and puts the phone. He talks to the helpline. To whom he tells them about his plane and this island. But due to some problem in the line, the person in front of him cannot hear him. Then he gets an idea. He makes her daughter to write all these things, and asks her to inform about this in his office. And then a man comes and attacks Brad. Then he catches him and beats him a lot. And makes him unconscious. Then Brad feels like someone is coming into this room. That's why he hides quickly. But there was no one else but Tony. Who had killed a lot of goons and took their weapons. And he starts calling out to Brad. But when Brad comes in front, he also gives him some weapons. After that, both of them start coming down. Then here they get a camera. From they come to know from the video that that dangerous private army kidnap the people who come. And then they take a lot of money from their family. In exchange for leaving them. As soon as they see, they understand that our passengers are also in danger. Now they both come and sit in the car outside. And start going toward their passengers. When all the passengers were sitting there, then they hear the sound of a car. Thinking this, they are very happy that it is Brad. But not Brad, there was that dangerous private army. They were shooting bullets and moving towards these people. Brad and Tony had also heard the sound of these bullets. The private army's head asks the pilot for the list of all the passengers. Then the air hostess quickly brings the list and gives it to him. Then the head asks, "Where is your senior pilot Brad?" On which he tells that he went to the jungle for some work. But has not returned yet. Meanwhile, a woman tries to run away from there. But they shoot and kill her. Hearing this, Brad runs to help her. But Tony stops him. The goons start putting all the passengers on the bus. Because they were taking them with him by making them prisoners. Their leader tells his two companions to go on the plane and bring all the necessary valuables. After which he himself takes all the passengers and leaves from here. Then Brad gets angry at Tony that he took our people, and you did not let me go. On which Tony explains to him that he was a very big army. They are dangerous people. If you had gone, you would not have been able to fight such a big army alone. But now these two were sad, but they move on. And catch two goons who were taking valuable things from the plane. Brad asks them at gunpoint where they would have gone with the passengers. On which he tells that there is an empty factory here. They must have gone there. Now the rescue expert had come to know about the situation there from Brad's daughter. That is, their plane is stuck on an island there. And there is also a very dangerous private army there. He tells about this to the owner of the plane company. On which he says that immediately send your private team and rescue team. Then these people quickly find that island and their plane. On which they decide that the leader of the private team will go there first with his team. On which Brad and Tony were going towards the factory by car. By coming near it, they sneak inside, where all those goons were making videos of passengers, to show which passenger is from which country. Now the private team also reaches near the plane. But when they do not see anyone there, the team leader goes inside the plane and checks where two dead bodies were. In addition to this, Brad's left message is also found there, which was the way to get to the factory. Both were hiding in the factory and keeping an eye on those goons. Out of which they come from behind and catch two goons and close their mouth and suffocate them, by which they die. Then they go ahead of the secret door. They reach outside the room. Inside that room, all the passengers were kept. There were a lot of guards standing there. Seeing whom, Tony gets very angry. That's why he picks up the hammer there and kills everyone one by one. Then Brad takes the keys from a goon and frees those passengers from the room. He then tells everyone to come near the plane as soon as possible, because I have asked for help through the radio. The rescue team must be coming. After which he makes everyone sit on the bus. Then Tony comes to him and tells that there are a lot of goons standing outside, so we can't get out of here. When he sees the passengers worried, he says that I will distract the passengers. While Tony, you take all the passengers from here. After saying this, Brad comes out of there and comes to the goons. He talks to their head that my team is coming here. That's why you leave my passengers. Now the goons come and start hitting him. And their head says, how can I leave it like this? I don't leave anyone without money. After which, as soon as he is about to kill Brad with a bullet, then the private team comes here and attacks them. The army shoots a lot, in which a lot of goons are killed. After which they start taking Brad and leaving from here. They sit on the bus and leave. The leader of the goons sees that along with the rest of the goons. My brother has also been killed. So he gets very angry. That's why he tells his team to hurry up. Get ready. And yes, don't leave anyone. Kill everyone one by one. Then Brad starts talking to that private team in the car. Then their head tells him that we are a small private team, who have just come to save you here. Because we are not a rescue team. There is still time for them to come. As soon as Brad gets nervous, he says that no problem. I have an idea. After this, these people also come near the plane, where all the passengers are brought there by Tony. Brad then tells his people that a private team has come here to help us. And now with their help, we will fly the plane. And we'll leave from here immediately. So, now everyone should sit on the plane quickly. Because we can't wait for the rescue team. There is still time for them to come. And if we stay here, we will be killed by that dangerous army. After hearing this, all the people sit on the plane. While Brad starts fixing the plane along with the leader of the private team, where the goons come and attack them. Seeing whom, the private team starts stopping them. And here a lot of bullets are fired from both sides. But this team had a lot of good guns. So they kill a lot of goons. Brad tells the leader of the team that I will start the plane in the next 5 minutes. Meaning I will take off. After which all of us will fly. Then he also thanks Tony that you supported me so much. Then Brad comes in between the bullets and sits down. And starts flying the plane along with his companion pilot. Tony's bullets were ended. And when he checks the bag of the private team, he finds a bag full of money there. But for now, he leaves the money and starts fighting the goons after taking the gun from the other bag. Until then, Brad has also turned the whole plane. Then that private team also starts climbing the plane. Brad is told by the owner of the plane company that I will tell you a safe place where you can go. All the people get on the plane, but Tony does not get on. He starts running away with a bag full of money. When he sees him going, the private army attacks his plane. Their head was thinking of bringing a rocket launcher in front of the plane and flying it in one shot. But Tony had seen him. He shoots him and drops him. He stops doing this. Seeing this, Brad is very happy. After which he succeeds in flying the plane with all his strength. Because of this, Tony was also happy and he also leaves from there. Brad takes the plane away from the island. While the owner of the plane tells him about the airport where these people could go, which was very close. Then Brad starts taking the plane to that side. But once again the plane starts getting destroyed. That's why Brad gets the emergency landing again. And after their plane comes down, the way to the jungle begins to move forward. Everyone's life was saved. That's why she was very happy. There, the owner of the plane company and his team were also very happy. Brad and his companion also take a breath of peace. That at least they had come out of that island. And everyone's life was also saved. In a while, her rescue team also comes here. Seeing this, all the passengers were happy. Also, they were clapping for Brad's bravery. Brad then sends all the passengers with the rescue team. After which he talks to his daughter. She was very happy with this. Thank God, my dad is alive. Both the daughters were very happy to talk. Along with this, the story of Brad's bravery ends here.